Peter the Great. A Jewish family in Rostov, whose ancestors had been Dutch, were keen to try to emulate the activities of Peter the Great of Russia when he had stayed in Holland. Through his example, they lathed ivory, made buckets, studied dentistry, wrote the letter R backwards, and learned to inscribe gold with a diamond. Every piece of the family's golden hoard had been inscribed: rings, bracelets, teething rings, lockets, brooches, table napkin rings, spoons, cigarette cases, fountain pens, hubcaps, and bath taps. And then it had all been confiscated by invading German soldiers. It was taken to Munich, where for a time, out of curiosity, it was kept together as a collection. But eventually, the itemized gold trinkets were separated from one another. The more august pieces found their way back to Leningrad, but some 18 smaller items started to travel in and out of the hands of middlemen and fences, until they arrived in Mainz, and then the smelting works at Baden-Baden. From there, they temporarily, and in another golden state, fell into the hands of Lieutenant Gustav Habsch and arrived at Bolzano, the worst place in Italy to taste a good spaghetti. In his enthusiasm for all things non-Russian in Europe, Peter the Great had thought of making spaghetti an important contribution to Russian cuisine. He had tasted it as cooked by the servants of Venetian silk merchants in the Amsterdam shipyards. In the event, he took back the secrets of making silk to St. Petersburg, and not the secrets of making good spaghetti. Commentators, determined to make Peter wiser and more prophetic than he could possibly have been, deliberated on Italy, silk and spaghetti, and found the correct connection in noodles, which is certainly manufactured in strands like silk, was probably taken back from China like silk by Marco Polo, and was most certainly introduced into Italy like silk via Venice. These were the commentators who were not slow to support Peter's suggestion that St. Petersburg was Russia's Venice. They endeavored to import Chinese cooks into Western Russia, but these unhappy exiles despaired of cooking good noodles, took up washing instead, and set up a St. Petersburg imperial laundry. The British are credited with being the first to invent, build, and run concentration camps at the time of the Boer War to imprison Dutch farmers, whose ancestors may have taught Peter diamond inscribing. But Peter had predated their initiative. He himself had kept a primitive concentration camp in Novgorod, harboring recalcitrant Cossacks who vehemently hated Peter's foreign enthusiasms, especially those learnt in the Netherlands. A land they thought was populated by people with webbed feet who ate tulip bulbs and would rather ride in a boat than on a horse.